Hey, and welcome to Smart Office, weekly tips and tricks to work around Microsoft Office applications. Today, I will show you something that has to do with Microsoft Outlook.
How to view info about email message headers in Microsoft Outlook. When we receive an email message, the header of the email message provides us with a lot of technical details about the actual message. These technical details can be information such as who sent the message, the software that was used to compose it, when it was sent, and even the email service that it passed until we received it. How can we find and see all these details? Just watch the video below. In Microsoft Outlook, we select a message that has arrived in our inbox. Once selected, from the Home tab of the ribbon, at the far right area of the ribbon, we see the View Headers command, which, if we press it, will open a pane to view the available headers on the current message. It retrieves the transport message headers of the current message and displays them in an easy-to-read format. If I select the Message Header Analyzer command, the Message Header Analyzer task pane will appear at the far right of our screen, where we have to wait until it loads all the necessary information. The Message Header Analyzer is separated in four different tabs. First, the summary, which we have the subject of the message ID, creation time, from, to. Then we have the received tab. If we press it, we see all the time and where, which service has it passed until it received to our inbox. Then we have the anti-spam tab. Forefront anti-spam report, country region D5, language, spam filtering verdict, IP filter verdict, and etc. And then we have the Microsoft anti-spam report. We have the other tab, which there is mentioning the authentication results, received SPF, DKIM filter, DKIM signature, and etc. And then we have the settings tab at the right area of the data of the message header analyzer, where we can change the user interface style into classic, new mobile. Whatever we select, we just press the OK button for the settings to be applied. Just in case you don't remember how to install an add-in, because this is a add-in, from the Home tab of the ribbon, under the area Add-ins, we select the Get Add-ins command. We wait for a minute until everything is loaded. And here in the text pane, we just type in which add-in we want to install and follow the instructions.
Thank you for watching. If you liked what you saw in this video, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, head down to the comment section and let me know.